Dave Chappelle's views on the Israel-Hamas war led to some scuffles with audience members during his comedy show in Boston. Now here's what he said. Dave Chappelle criticized Israel's bombing of Gaza and accused the United States of aiding the slaughter of innocent civilians. In the show at TD Garden on Thursday, Chappelle first condemned the October 7th attack on Israel by Hamas militants, but criticized what he said were war crimes in Gaza, according to people in attendance. Now, he made these comments, they came up at first when he said that he did not feel that students should lose job offers over their opinions in regard to Israel and their treatment of Palestinians. According to the account of Suher Nafal, who actually was there at the show, this is what happened, and pay close attention because Chappelle's response to one of the audience members was pretty incredible and very aggressive. I saw Dave Chappelle last night at Boston TD Garden. It was sold out, so I would say 22,000 people were there. 3/4 into the show, he said, quote, "I want to address what's going on in Palestine and Israel. What happened on October 7th wasn't right, but also what's going on isn't right and not just," meaning what's currently transpiring in Gaza. "You can't kill innocent civilians like that and the whole world sits silently and watches." Then someone shouted at him from the crowd, "Shut the F up, Dave." Now Chappelle clearly was not amused by being told to shut the F up by an audience member, and here's how he responded to this person. "No, you shut the F up. You don't take tens of billions from my country to go kill innocent women and children and come and tell me to shut the F up. Don't come begging for money from my country and then go drop bombs on children and cut off innocent people's water and electricity. You have the audacity to pay to come see me and then tell me to shut the F up. No, you shut the F up." And obviously they didn't censor themselves the way I'm censoring right now on the show. Some audience members actually cheered Chappelle on and shouted "Free Palestine," while others yelled, "What about Hamas?" Like, as I mentioned, he did address Hamas and condemned what Hamas did. But others did get up and leave. They felt offended by what he had to say about Israel's treatment of Palestinians in the Gaza Strip. So Cenk, what are your thoughts? Chappelle got a lot of heat from the left. I'm curious how they feel about him now.
Well, I'm also curious how the right wing feels about him, because I see now people online saying that Chappelle should be canceled. Oh, what happened? I thought you didn't want to cancel him. Oh, so when he was attacking people you didn't like, you thought he should be protected. But when he criticizes people that you're in favor of, all of a sudden you want to cancel him. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, so I told you when I was criticizing him, I don't think he should be canceled. People are allowed to do a show, people are allowed to go to the show, okay? I saw his last special, I thought it wasn't funny at all. And so am I forced to like it? No, I'm not forced to like it. I bothered to watch it and I didn't like it, okay? So that's how the world works. So this show, again, I'm not sure what this has to do with comedy, but I appreciated that he spoke out on this issue and I agree with him. What Hamas did was terrible, what Israel's doing is terrible. Look, these charges of anti-Semitism are weaponized and I can't stand it. And so, especially in a world that is filled with anti-Semitism, don't go around making false charges based on politics. Oh, you don't like innocent Palestinians being killed? You're an anti-Semite. No, okay, you just ruined it. And that you become the boy who cried wolf. The things that Dave Chappelle, a reporter, is having said there are perfectly normal things to say. And I appreciate that he actually cared about other human beings and stuck up for them. I was a little surprised by that. So thank you, Dave Chappelle.
It's really hard for Israel's government, along with its allies, meaning the United States, to spin what Israel is doing as anything but what it appears to be, which is ethnic cleansing of Palestinians from that area. Okay, you see the images, you see the absolutely destroyed and leveled communities in Gaza. And as those images and those videos come out and as the world sees it, it's gonna be increasingly difficult to convince people that the reaction and retaliation coming from the Israeli government makes any sense or is justified. War crimes are war crimes. You can't just turn a blind eye to war crimes because a government you like or a country you like is carrying them out. And that seems to be the case with some portion of the population at the moment, But again, it's gonna be increasingly difficult to provide cover for what's going on as we continue to see entire families get wiped out, as we continue to see resistance from the Israeli government in allowing fuel to get into the Gaza Strip to allow these hospitals to run and operate properly. One of the arguments that they make is, well, if we provide fuel, then the Hamas will have electricity to light up their tunnels underground. You know, they can just use candles and stuff. Like, if that's really your argument for denying the Palestinian people, including their hospitals, the fuel necessary to function properly, it's a pathetic excuse, in my opinion.
But you can't use candles to light up an incubator.
Exactly.
Or an ICU unit in a hospital. You need power for that. You need electricity for that. Everyone that's hooked up to that grid is about to die. Israel is now finally allowing Egypt to send in some goods, but not fuel. You know how much of it? They're sending in about 4% of what used to go in normally.
Right.
So these people are going to get starved.
It's a slow, torturous, painful death that every single person living in the Gaza Strip right now is currently dealing with. That is what's happening. Let's just be clear about that.
If Hamas had held all of Israel hostage like this, and they were slowly killing all the Israelis, and you knew that there were all those babies that were about to lose power and then die in those incubators, and you knew all the people, the grandmothers, the moms, etc., that were hooked up to those machines that are life-saving and they're about to lose power, what wouldn't you do to protect those Israelis? We're asking you to do the same thing, and in this case, just something simple. Put pressure on Israeli and US governments to stop the siege, to ask for a ceasefire. It isn't picking sides to do a ceasefire. And if you're worried about, oh, well, it's not even yet. Well, Israel killed 3 times as many civilians as Hamas killed civilians. So when does it become even? Do you need 5-1, 10-1? How much retribution do you need? So if you're cared about it being quote unquote even, it is more than even now. Can we please do the ceasefire now? No. When anybody asks for the ceasefire, anti-Semitic. Yeah, that is played out. So, and you're doing great damage to the cause of protecting Jews in this country and across the world by misusing the label of anti-Semitism against good, decent people who are trying to save innocent lives.
Now, there's a strange part to this story, and I want to be clear that what you're about to hear is a complete and utter lie. A spokesperson for Chappelle, contacted by the Wall Street Journal, denied that Dave Chappelle even had a show in Boston, or denied that Chappelle was even in Boston on the night that the show actually did happen and did occur. It's just I don't know why this spokesperson said it, because it's a clownish thing to say, given the fact that it was a promoted event. Let me show you some of the promotional material that was put out ahead of the event. Dave Chappelle, it's a celebration, October 19th.
At TD Garden.
Okay.
In Boston. That's where TD Garden is.
In fact, the audience members were given some merch, including tote bags, like the one you're seeing in the photo here.
Does Chappelle have a doppelganger we're not familiar with? So look, I don't know if there's something off with Chappelle. He's done some strange things, or I don't know if it's just a spokesperson, right? There's nothing wrong with what you said. Why have your spokesperson go out and lie like that for no reason? It makes you look weird. So at least they should correct that on the record. But in terms of what he said about Israel, there's nothing wrong with it.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.